Okay, so good morning. We have been looking at the steam turbines, and in the last class, we looked at what do you mean by steam turbine, what are the different classifications, and we looked at some velocity triangles for nimble stage and two-stage turbine and all. Today, we look into the expressions for work done and blade efficiency, and we'll derive the condition for maximum work done and maximum efficiency. Let's consider this velocity triangle. So whatever I have written, V1, VR1 and U is for the velocity triangle at the inlet. One corresponds to inlet velocity triangle, and two corresponds to outlet velocity triangle. Okay. And you know that from the Euler's expression. See, one before I could show this, my VW1 and VW2, my VW2 is in opposite direction of your VW1. So if VW1 is in this direction, the VW2 is in opposite direction, so it will be minus of VW2. We know the expressions for the work done, so we have the work done expression. We have the work done expression from the Euler equation. What is it actually? It is W is equal to VW1 minus of VW2. Okay. Let me write that. W is equal to, we have already derived this. W is equal to VW1 minus VW2 into U. As my VW2 is in opposite direction, so it is minus of VW2. So what I will do, I will change it to VW1 minus of minus, that is plus VW2. Into 2, I call this as equation number 1. Okay. Now let us consider the velocity triangle. That is, from the outlet velocity triangle or exit velocity triangle, what is my cos beta 2? So cos beta 2 is equal to, okay, my cos beta 2 is equal to VW2, see, cos beta 2 is equal to VW1 minus U. So cos beta 2 is equal to, sorry, VW1, sorry, inlet velocity, from the inlet velocity. Just to write for inlet, then we will go out it. From the inlet velocity triangle, cos beta 1 is equal to, if I call this as x is equal to VW1 minus U. So this is x divided by your VR1, or I can write cos beta 1 is equal to VW1 minus U divided by VR1. Okay, or I can write VW1 is equal to so U, VW1 as it is, so it will be U plus VR1 into cos beta 1. I'm calling that as expression 2. Okay. Similarly, from the exit velocity triangle, we have cos beta 2 is equal to VW2 plus U divided by VR2, or from this I can write VW2 is equal to VR2 cos beta 2 minus U. I am calling that as expression number 3. Okay. Substitute for VW1 and VW2 in equation 1. substitute for VW1 and VW2 in equation 1. If I do that, VW1 is equal to what? So W is equal to U plus VR1 cos beta 1, okay, plus VW2 is equal to VR2 cos beta 2 minus U, whole thing multiplied by U. So if I try to open the bracket, this will be U plus VR1 cos beta 1 plus VR2 cos beta 2 minus U into U. So plus U, minus U just simply cancel out. I'm left with W is equal to U into VR1 cos beta 1 plus VR2 cos beta 2. So this is my expression. So what I will do, I will take my VR1 cos beta 1 outside. So W is equal to U into VR1 cos beta 1 outside. If I take, it is 1 plus VR2 cos beta 2 divided by VR1 cos beta 1. So this is the expression what I have. Now, if I call this as equation 4. Let me call this as equation number 4. Let us define, say there is a friction and all. Let us define CB or KB. CB or KB, whatever it may be, is equal to VR2 by VR1. And let's define one more factor, K. K is equal to cos beta 2 divided by cos beta 1. So why I'm defining this particular thing is actually, so most of the impulse steam turbines, if beta 1 will be equal to beta 2, so delayable turbines and all, if you look at, in that case, K will be equal to 1. And if there is no friction factor, that means the fluid will flow on the blade without, it will be a completely idealistic, vane congruent kind of a flow, then VR1 will be equal to VR2. In that case, CV will be equal to 1. So that is the idealistic conditions. So in that case, the right hand side, this term will be 1 plus, it will be, so it will be 1. So it will be 2. So that is a condition. Okay. Now, so this is the expression. So what we have, I can write it as W is equal to U into VR1 into cos beta 1 into 1 plus CB into K. So this is the expression. Now, we have from your inlet velocity triangle. So what is my inlet velocity triangle? I can write your alpha. What is your cos alpha? I can write it as, I can replace for VR cos beta 1. I can write your cos beta 2 in terms of cos alpha. So cos beta 2, we have this particular thing. Wherever we have cos beta 1. So we have this cos beta 1. So here, what is my VW1? So VW1 is equal to your cos beta 1 is equal to V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into VR1 cos beta 1. Or I can write VR1 cos beta 1 as V1 cos alpha 1 minus U. Okay. So I'll replace VR1 cos beta 1 as W is equal to U into V1 cos alpha 1, okay, minus U into 1 plus CB into K. So this is the expression for work done, a generalized expression for work done. So I'm trying to get this, I'm trying to get this expression in terms of alpha, U, and you have CB and K. Now, for a given value of alpha, see, for a given value of alpha 1 and a speed n. Speed n means u also will become constant. Cv is also constant. And I have k. So then, these are the variables. So if I keep my alpha constant, and Cv is constant, and k is constant, so n I can have a variable. So n will become a variable. Okay. Or I can keep speed constant, I can vary alpha. So both possibilities are there. So most of the things what we try to do is actually we try to get the work done based on alpha as the constant and varying, you getting the variable as a speed. Okay, speed we are going to vary. So what we do to maximize the work done, so what we do, we differentiate dw with respect to u and equate it to 0. So what it is actually, d by du is equal to u into v1 cos alpha 1 minus u square. Okay, anyway, the other thing is constant, so I can take it out, it is 1 plus cb into k, so this automatically becomes constant, I need not differentiate. So I need to differentiate only the first quantity. So the differentiation of d by this particular thing will be, the first one will be v1 cos alpha 1 minus differentiation of u square is equal to 2u is equal to 0, or I can write v1 cos alpha 1 is equal to 2u, or I can write u is equal to v1 cos alpha 1 by 2. This will be the condition. So let me call that as equation 6. So substitute u in 5. Substitute u in equation 5 to get w max. So what will be my w max in that case? W max is equal to, wherever u is there, so I can write v1 cos alpha 1 by 2. So v1 cos alpha 1 minus u is equal to v1 cos alpha 1 by 2.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Are you using product rule in the differentiation part?
Product?
Product rule in the differentiation. Oh, yes. Sorry. Then you should multiply it to 1 plus cv into k, right?
No, this is just a constant. That constant I'm taking out. Why you want to differentiate the constant?
Oh, sir, if you are using the multiplication rule.
No. See, this constant, what I will do, so I can take it out, I can bring it out as a constant. I simplified. I did not differentiate it.
Yeah, then you need to put it outside, right?
I will put it, that's what, see, just I wrote it, see. I can write, see, this particular thing only, I will differentiate only this particular, this is automatically constant, that's it. I can remove it. So why you want, see, even if you multiply and get back, you'll end up with the same answer. That will be a little lengthy. Your final answer will be the same, because that's a constant, no?
Yes, sir.
That's a constant. You need not worry about the constant. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, this constant I removed. Anyway, I thought like, just write that, pull that to the zero by that particular constant will become zero. Okay? Then, so if I write it here, it is 1 plus Cb into K, fine. So now multiply V1 cos alpha 1 by 2. So if I multiply this, this will be V1 square cos square alpha 1 by 2 minus V1 square cos square alpha 1 by 4. So it is half minus quarter, it is 1 by 4 into 1 plus Cb into k. So I am left with my W max is equal to V1 square cos square alpha 1 by 4 into 1 plus Cb into k. So this is the expression for maximum work time. Now, for an ideal condition, what will happen? For an ideal condition, what is the ideal condition means? I don't have any friction, that is Cb is equal to 1. And for an impulse case, for an ideal condition, and impulse case, this is being an impulse case, my cos beta 1 is equal to cos beta 2, that is beta 1 is equal to beta 2, so k is equal to 1. So what will happen to this expression? Therefore, my W max is equal to V1 square cos square alpha 1 divided by 4 into 2. So it is here 2, it is 4, this is 1. Fine. Because this quantity turns out to be 2. So have 2 here. Let me write that. Then next step I'll write it. So this is 2. This is 2. Then this is 4. This will be 1 plus 1 into 1. So that is a step actually. So therefore W max is equal to V1 cos square alpha 1 divided by 4 into 2 into V1 square cos square alpha 1 by 2. So this will be expression 8. So idealistic condition means I don't have any friction. And for an impulse case means my beta 1 is equal to beta. So this is the expression for maximum work done. Now similarly, what will be the expression for your blade efficiency or hydraulic efficiency? See, expression for hydraulic or blade efficiency. What it is actually, it is the ratio of work done, already we have defined, just I'm writing again, divided by kinetic energy at inlet to the turbine. So that is V1 square by 2. So that is your W divided by V1 square by, so this is the thing. Just now we saw the expression for work done. So what is the expression for work done we derived? It is U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into 1 plus CB into K divided by V1 square by 2. So in the examination, if they ask to derive only hydraulic efficiency, then this has to be derived. So you start the derivation till the equation 5. So till equation 5, then you substitute here. Then you substitute in your blade equation and you proceed. So here already I have done, I don't want to repeat it again. So I will take that equation 5. This is derived till equation 5. So you derive that particular point and substitute over here. Now, once you have done that, now further simplify this expression. So this will be, so 2 will go to the numerator. This will be 2 into U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into 1 plus CB into K divided by V1 square by 2. Okay. So if I open the bracket, this will be 2 into U into V1, so V1 into cos alpha 1. If I take V1 outside, here this will be U by V1 into 1 plus CB into K divided by V1 square by 2. So I am calling this as equation number. So equation number 2. Because if I call this as equation number 1, so that is equation number 2. Now look at this, already we know. So let the speed ratio phi is equal to
u by v1. Let the speed ratio is equal to u by v1. So if that is the case, then the blade efficiency will be 2 into u into v1 into cos alpha 1 minus your u by v1. I can write it as phi. Fine. U by v, I can write it as phi into 1 plus cb into k. I am calling this as equation number 3. See, 2 is one expression where I am writing the expression in terms of your u and v. If I want the same expression, if you want in terms of phi, if they ask you to obtain the blade expression in terms of phi, I have to get it this. Or maybe the idealistic conditions means what will happen, cb will be equal to 1. If it is for an impulse case, this will be 2. So this will be 4 times u into this. So you can write in whatever the way we want. So this is the expression. So sometimes it will be 1 plus kb into maybe your the blade angle ratios, few books they call it as b. It all depends on the what kind of nomenclature we use. Okay. Now, how to maximize this? So for maximum, already we are done. See, already for maximum efficiency, I use the same W max condition. What is it? U is equal to V1 cos alpha 1 divided by 2. Fine. So then your maximum efficiency.
Sir, in above equation, it should be divided by V1.
Divided by?
Divided by V1. Efficiency B equal to divided by V1.
Yes. We missed out. V1 square by 2. V1 square actually. You have to divide it by V1 square. Okay. One minute. We missed out. This is V1 square. We missed out here. V1 square. Then, next expression will be. I think I missed out here. It will be. Then it will be 2 into u into cos alpha 1 minus phi into 1 plus cb into k divided by v1. Divided by V1. The screen shared? I think there is some issue. So now it's fine. So this is equation number 3. This is my equation number 3. Yeah, fine. So this is my equation number 3. If I try to substitute the condition for u here, so this will be 2 times your v1 cos alpha 1 divided by 2 into cos alpha 1 minus, see, I can leave phi. See, if they ask you in terms of phi, I need not substitute for u. So that's one thing. So what I will do is I will take the expression equation number 2 and try to substitute here. Fine, I will take the equation 2 and substitute here. So if equation 2 means u will be equal to v1 cos alpha 1 divided by. So I have your V1. So V1. So it is V1 as
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
In equation 3, can we substitute u by V1 as phi?
Yes. So
2 phi into cos alpha minus.
Yes. See, that is only the numerator will get converted to phi. That's it.
So just to see, that is, see, equation 2 is fine. You got your blade efficiency. Sometimes they may ask, so we may write the expression in terms of speed ratio. That's it. So take the V1 as the common outside. So to you, V1 if you take outside, this expression, if you take this expression, 2U V1 into 2U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus. So if you take V1 outside, this will be cos alpha 1 minus U by V1. That's it. So U by V1, I'm writing it as V. See, either 2 is just sufficient for us. So for our derivation expression for blade efficiency, equation 2 is just sufficient. The same equation 2 can be written in terms of phi. That's it. Just to show in other form of it. For maximizing and all, we'll take only equation 2. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank
okay,
you.
Fine.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Can you explain me how did you get V1 square by 2 in the equation above the second equation?
Equation, see, equation V1 square by 2 is the kinetic energy available at the inlet.
Yeah.
What is kinetic energy? V square by 2.
Yes,
so what, is the kinetic energy available at the inlet to the turbine? It is V1 square by 2.
Yes, sir. You have written 2U into U1 cos alpha 1 minus U into 1 plus
A. No. 2 has to go to the numerator. That's it. It is V1 square divided by V1 square. 2 has to go to the numerator. That's it. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, in this expression, it is V1 cos alpha 1 divided by V1, okay, into 1 plus CV into K. Now, 2 you can just cancel out, or you have to take, see, 2 has to be multiplied by here. 2 just cancel out. I'm left with actually your blade max is equal to your, at that numerator, say denominator, I have V1 square. See, denominator, so numerator, denominator, I have V1 square. So I am having as it is, because I am taking the equation 2. Okay. Same thing I can further simplify as blade efficiency is equal to V1 cos alpha 1 into cos alpha 1 minus V1 will go off. It is cos alpha 1. So it is 2 is there, no? Yeah, 2 V1 cos alpha 2 into 2 into U into V1 cos, here I have put, yeah, here I have, it is cos alpha 1 by 2 into 1 plus CD into K whole thing divided by V1 square. Okay. Now, 1 V1 square will just simply cancel out. I'm left with, so further simplification, if you want, you can do that simplification. I can directly get this will be cos alpha 1 into cos alpha 1 minus cos alpha 1 by 2 into 1 plus CB into K whole thing divided by V1. Sorry, V1 square will just simply go and left with V1. Yeah, V1 square. Yes, V1 square. So V1 will go off. 1 V1 will go off because that's a common for everything. So I'm left with V1. Now, what will be the condition? So this will be, so further simplification, I can write it as this will be, so cos alpha 1, which is cos alpha 1, so this will be cos square alpha 1, okay, divided by V1 into 1 plus CB into K. We are left one thing, no? It will be something. Yeah, V1 is there, no? 1 V1 is here, sorry. We left out 1 V1 here. So we have 1 V1, 1 V1 square root of, yeah. We have only V1, sorry. We don't have V1 square, it is only V1. So that also will go off. We have only,
sir, it should be divided by 2.
No, divided by, or no, not by 2 has, two, gone to the, 2 has gone to the numerator. 2 has gone to the numerator already. It is only V1. It is not V1 square.
Sir, in the bracket, cos alpha 1 minus cos alpha 1 by 2 will be cos alpha 1 by 2.
Which one? Cos alpha, which equation?
In the last equation, sir.
Okay.
In the last equation.
Cos alpha 1? Yeah, cos alpha 1 by 2.
So yeah, cos alpha 1 minus cos alpha 1 by 2 will be cos alpha 1 by 2 into
yes.
cos alpha 1. Cos into, square alpha
yeah,
1.
That's what, that's what, that's what. V1 will go off. It is 2. Cos square alpha 1 by 2 into 1 plus, see, I thought it is V1 square, it is V1. V1 is there. V1 just they simply cancel out. Because V1 square was there, no? One of the V1 is already cancelled. See, this V1, this one V1, this, they already cancelled. And left with only V1 here. So, I thought it is V1 square. Okay? So, this V1, okay. They cancel out. So, I'm left with only V1. So, V1 will go off. I'm left with this thing. So, it will be cos square alpha 1 divided by into 1 plus CB into K. Now, this equation, I'm calling it as equation number 4. This I'm equation calling it as. This is the maximum efficiency or maximum dead efficiency condition. Now, here also I have, see, for an frictionless, for frictionless flow, CB is equal to 1. And for an impulse condition, K is equal to 1. I'm left with is equal to cos square alpha 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus 1 into 1. So, that also will become 2. So, your maximum blade efficiency is equal to cos square alpha 1. So, equation 5 is the expression for maximum efficiency under ideal conditions. Otherwise, it is cos square alpha 1 by 2 into 1 plus your friction coefficient or whatever the coefficient KB or CB multiplied by the ratio of cos with respect to blade angle beta 2 by beta 1. That is blade angle at the outlet to blade angle at the inlet. Fine. Now, see, I have told that we have the condition. So, these are the conditions what we have. We have this condition. What is this condition? See, my corresponding V2 or V2 will be equal to Vf or my whirl velocity will be 0 for this condition. So, your U will be equal to Vw1 by 2 or whatever this particular condition. So, V1 cos alpha 1 or V1 cos alpha 1 is my Vw. So, V1 cos alpha is my Vw. Indirectly, if I write, this will be Vw1 by 2, indirectly. That means, what will happen if I try to take this triangle? Yeah, if I try to take this particular triangle, try to analyze it. Try to take this triangle for this condition, what will happen? So, I have this condition. So, I have the two conditions. What are the two actually? This Vf2, this Vf2 or this V2 has to reach this stage. My V2 for maximum, my V2 has to come to this condition so that my Vr will be at this condition. So, this will be my Vr2. This will be my Vf2, which is also equal to V2. For this condition, my Vw2 will be equal to 0. What is it? I am trying to maximize my blade efficiency. U will be equal to your Vw. So, this x, this particular, this quantity, you know, this will be exactly your U will be, see, this is the whole thing is exactly divided. So, this will be Vw 1 by 2. This will be Vw 1 by 2. Because this is equal to U for maximizing bed efficiency. If that is the condition, what will happen? Your the work done, the condition for this condition. And for this actually, what will happen? Your beta 1 will be equal to beta 2. So, we have certain conditions. So this we can look at when we try to solve into some numericals. So the corresponding, the velocity triangle, the conditions will look something like this. We can write some comments. What are those comments? For, so this was the condition what we started with. Vw is equal to, Vw1 plus Vw2 into u. And for this condition, if my Vw2 is equal to 0, what will happen? It is only Vw1 into u. And beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Or I can write, what is your Vw2? See, if my u is equal to Vw1 by 2, or your Vw1 is equal to 2 times c. Okay, what will be your W max? If Vw1 is equal to 2 times u, therefore my W max is equal to 2u into u, or 2u square. So this is my maximum work what we can get for this condition from the velocity triangle, just by substituting into velocity triangle, which when we try to solve some numericals, we'll try to analyze this. This is how it looks like actually. This is the for the work, a impulse kind of a case, for an impulse case actually. And here, there are certain things. One more thing we have to look into. That means, when we try to go for stage efficiencies. Stage efficiency. What is it actually? Stage efficiency means, we try to expand using a turbine. Okay, on HS diagram, we try to write something like this. So I will show for two stages. Okay, I'll show for two stages. If this is my HS diagram and these are my pressure curves, fine, these are my pressure curves, how the expansion will take place? See, expansion, if it is a complete single stage expansion, it will be something like this. Something like this. From, let's suppose this is P1, P2, P3, 1, 2 dash, 3 dash. So if it is in stages, if I try to expand it, how it looks like? It expands to 2n. Fine. Then it may go to 3. So what will be a single stage? This will be from 3 double dash. So stage-wise, if I try to expand, it will be like this. So stage efficiency means I do have something happens in a stator and something happens in a rotor. So stage means, if I write in terms of stage efficiency, stage efficiency means the efficiency of the stator multiplied by efficiency of the rotor. Fine. What is this stator? This is your nozzle. The rotor, it is either blade efficiency or vane efficiency. So if I write for the nozzle, what we try to do, it is actually the kinetic energy available with the fluid divided by your enthalpy in that nozzle, the enthalpy drop in that nozzle. Fine. So if I write for the your blade, just now we saw it is work done by energy available with the fluid. So if I try to simplify this, the stage efficiency will be work done by enthalpy of that particular thing. What happens in that? So nozzle means it is, once again we call it as stage. Or what happens in that particular? We look into that, the nozzle enthalpy drop as a stage enthalpy drop. So that's why this is the enthalpy drop or enthalpy drop. What we try to do, we try to put it in a Mollier diagram. Say we try to move along a particular pressure, whatever may be the temperature. From there, we draw a vertical line. And wherever it touches the corresponding the exit pressure, we'll try to see that. So that is your isentropic. If it is an actual one, we will know what is that particular, what is the condition. So we will do it. So what it is, let me try and show that. So in an HS diagram, it is something like this. This is what visually we drew. So if this is a dome in our Mollier diagram, we move on a particular pressure and we have a particular temperature. If it's a, if it is something we call it as a superheated thing, fine. We'll get this condition. So from that condition, we'll drop it. Whether it is dry, whether it is particular, maybe wet condition, whatever may be, we'll get this condition. Or if it is somewhere in the superheated condition itself, it may be come to particular dye, then it may go to particular thing. It will go to, that's how we reheating and all we try to do. Then it may go to the same pressure or some lower pressure at the same temperature. These are the same temperature. This is what happens in most of the HS diagram. Then from there, we'll try to drop it. This is what happens in most of the steam turbines. So this may be for first two stages, high pressure stages. This may be for the next two stages or one stage of. So each stage wise, what we take after expansion, the particular steam may become drier, it may be near dry. If I try to expand further from without converting it to superheated, what will happen? I may go to a very low quantity of the steam at the exit of your maybe turbine, which is causing damage to your turbine blades. So what we do, we try to reheat it. Okay, that we do it actually. Now, when you come to blade efficiency or your stage efficiency, whatever this, all this enthalpy is what we try to do. No, this is where this is very important for us. Enthalpy changes, that's what. So this is because we try to look at the enthalpy gained or enthalpy. So stage efficiency or stage enthalpy drop or whatever they see, it is nothing but the cumulative of all the enthalpy changes that's occurring over time. All the things we'll try to look into that. So this is very important. And when we take up some numericals, we'll try to I want you people to look into the steam tables. So any related, whatever may be the steam table, we look into the steam table and we'll try to calculate that enthalpy and we'll try to solve it. Okay, so this is about your impulse cases, a single stage impulse cases. Look into the Parsons turbine. Let's come to Parsons turbine. One minute, I'll share. There's some issue. I'll share. This is about your Parsons turbine. Yeah, fine. So this is your Parsons turbine. This is your Parsons reaction turbine. See, Parsons reaction turbine is one very special kind of a turbine. See why this is, even today, this was maybe an engineer by name Charles Parsons. I think he invented this particular turbine maybe hundreds of years back, but still it is used in most of the steam turbines. It's very efficient. See, what the peculiarity of this particular steam turbine is, it has a degree of reaction of 0.5. That means whatever the 50% it is your pressure enthalpy, the pressure energy getting converted, and 50% it is kinetic energy. So it's a 50-50 kind of a turbine. And when you have such a condition, R is equal to 0.5, you can verify that what will happen, your flow angles will be equal to your alpha 1. So if I try to put into a velocity triangle for this condition, for r is equal to 0.5, I will end up with alpha 1 is equal to beta 2 and beta 2 is equal to alpha, beta 2 alpha 1 is equal to beta 2 and your beta 2 is equal to alpha 1. This condition automatically it comes up. So we'll come to the thing. What is it? So I have put the stator, one single stage of it, one stator and one rotor I have given. And stator is nothing but the rosal. See, the fluid is flowing like this. Okay. And you can see in the rotor, in impulse we have seen, it was like a bucket. It was like a bucket. Here, it is like an aerofoil cross structure. See, here, it is an aerofoil cross section. So, there is no uniformity. Beta 2 is equal to beta 1 is what we study in impulse case, because it was like most of the thing where it's like a bucket type, a blade type or bucket type actually. Here, it's an aerofoil structure. So, beta 1 and beta 2 are not equal, but there is some relationship exists if for r is equal to 0.5 with respect to beta 2 and your alphas. Now, what happens here? The pressure drops in the nozzle, and you can see the pressure is also dropping in your rotor. The velocity increases in your stator, and the velocity is also dropping. So, you can see the velocity is also getting inverse. That is because of the kinetic energy. And you can see there is a pressure is also dropping. That's mainly because of the pressure energy. So both my pressure energy and kinetic energy, they are all in terms of 50-50 percentage in this kind of a turbine. They come out. So that's why it is called as a 50% degree of reaction turbine. So both are 50. So that means they run almost like, if it go in terms of the values or in terms of numbers, it is exactly they are identical. Okay. Now to the right hand side, I have your triangle. So I can draw this kind of a triangle, or I can have the other type of a triangle, maybe to the down also. So if one is my inlet velocity triangle, that is V1, VF1, VR1. So this is my VR1 and this is my beta1, this is my beta2. Okay. And we have VW2, VR2, V2 and VF. So these are the conditions with respect to exit velocity triangle. I can do this. So here one peculiar thing, if you look at it actually, you have this beta 1, you have this beta 1, see this particular beta 1, and beta 1 is equal to your exit, see, this will be equal to your exit, that means the fluid enters at some angle at the inlet, whatever the angle the fluid enters. Here, whenever I call your alpha 1 is equal to beta 2, and my alpha 2 is equal to beta 1. See, the fluid enters at some angle. So whatever the angle it enters, so that will be your exit blade angle. Are you getting my point? So whatever the flow angle, see, that's the condition, design condition. This is the flow angle at the inlet will be your exit blade angle. Fine. Then the flow angle at the exit will be equal to your blade angle at the inlet. So under this condition only, I'll be able to get this R is equal to 0.5. Are you getting? So this is the condition for your Parsons reaction curve. So the blade angles are identical. That means blade angles are beta 1 is equal to beta 2. And for maximum efficiency, look at the maximum efficiency. There's a condition we can get it. Blue max is equal to what? Or we can get the similar expression for your blade efficiency, that is eta b max also we can get. Okay. Now, let us derive, still we have on the 5-10 minutes. Let's derive the expression for work. So let's derive the expression for work done in the Parsons turbine. Expression for work done. It is similar to what we derived for this thing. There will be a little bit of changes. So already we know your W is equal to VW1 minus of minus, that is VW2 into you. This comes from your Euler expressions, Euler equation. Okay. Now, from the velocity triangles, at the inlet and exit, what is cos alpha 1? Cos alpha 1 is equal to, if you look at it, cos alpha 1 is equal to, you have your VW1 divided by V1. Cos alpha 2 is equal to VW2 divided by V2. And similarly, cos beta 2 is equal to cos beta 2 is equal to VW2 plus U divided by VR2. So I have these expressions. So cos alpha 1 is equal to VW1 divided by V1, or I can write VW1 is equal to V1 cos alpha 1. Similarly, cos alpha 2 is equal to VW2 by 2, or VW2 is equal to V2 cos alpha 2. Similarly, cos beta 1 is equal to cos beta 2, the exit triangle. So it is cos beta 2 is equal to VW2 plus U divided by VR2. If you want, I can write the same velocity triangle. Take this velocity triangle and write it. This is your velocity triangle. Now cos beta 2 is equal to VW2 plus U, and this is in opposite direction, same velocity. Now if I substitute, see what is my here, what is my VW2? VW2 is equal to here I can write it as this from this particular thing. I can write VW2 is equal to VR2 cos beta 2 minus U. Fine. So I can write, these are some of the things what I have, either in terms of VR1 cos beta 1, fine, or in terms of this thing. So I will write this expression and this expression. I need not use, this is, if I call this as 1, so this as 1. So I will call this as 2 and 3. See, I have this particular, I am not using that. So substituting 2 and 3 in equation 1. Substitute 2 and 3 in equation 1. See, here I can write, see why I am writing this, I can get the same expression in terms of beta or in terms of alpha. Both the ways is possible. Okay.
This is alpha 2.
Okay. 2 and 3.
We call this as 3. We call this as 4.
2 and 4. In 1. 2 and 4 in 1. Okay. So what I'm going to get actually, these are the different ways of writing. That's it. So W is equal to V1 cos alpha 1 plus VR2 cos beta 2 minus U into U. Okay. Now, why I am not writing this particular thing? If you look at it, your cos alpha 2 is equal to beta 1. See what will happen here. This is the condition. So I have this as equation 5. For a Parsons turbine, see, whenever for R is equal to 0.5, for R is equal to 0.5, my VR1 is equal to V2. My VR1, for R is equal to 0.5, sir, VR2 is equal to V1. VR2 is equal to V1. My VR2, this is my VR2, this is my VR2 is equal to V1. For degree of reaction, that means both the energy should be same. See, this and this should be same. That is the meaning of it. For degree of reaction, that means the whole velocity triangle, see, whatever the area covered by one velocity triangle, one, if I call this as ABC, see, if you call this as ABC, fine, and ABD, see, the both the velocity triangle should be same. That's the meaning of R is equal to 0.5, degree of reaction 0.5. That's the meaning of it. So when R is equal to 0.5, VR2 is equal to V1. VR2 is equal to V1 for this condition. So what will happen? Your alpha 1 is equal to beta 2. When VR2 is equal to V1, your alpha 1 is equal to beta 2. So those are the conditions what we have to look into it. So this is for only for R is equal to 0.5, because I am trying to have the similar energy levels, whether it's a pressure energy or your kinetic energy. So for this condition, what will happen? My W is equal to V1 cos alpha 1, okay, plus VR2 is equal to V1. I will write it as V1 beta 2 is equal to beta 1. So I will write it as alpha 1 minus U into U. Okay. So this will be W is equal to 2 times V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into U. Or I can write the same expression in terms of beta. Or I can write your W is equal to 2 times V1 cos beta 2 minus U into U. This I am calling it as. So this is the expression for your W in terms of your alpha 1 and beta 2. If you want, you can open the bracket. So it will be 2V1 cos alpha 1 into U minus 2V1. So V1 cos alpha, so that into minus U square. So it will be, I can do whatever you want. Or the same thing if I want in terms of phi. What is phi actually? Phi is nothing but V. So the same expression, 6, I can write it as in different way. If I define, let phi is equal to U by V1. So 6, I can write it as W is equal to, if I can take V1 outside, if I take V1 outside or V1 square outside, whatever I can do, I can take V1 outside if I take it. Or V1 square, let's take V1 square outside. If I take V1 square outside, what this will be? 2 into cos alpha 1 into U by V1 minus U square by V1 square, or this will be V1 square into 2 into cos alpha 1 into phi minus phi square. The same thing, if I write in terms of beta, the same thing, it will be W is equal to V1 square into 2 times cos beta 2 phi minus phi square. So this is writing the same expression in terms of phi. So I can write in terms of expression in terms of phi or expression in terms of this. Okay. We'll stop here. the next class, what we'll look at, we'll try to look into the expression for stage efficiencies.